This is the most important video I have ever made. What's good? It's your boy Zachary Carroll, aka Pastor Z, and this is ChristianHood Talk, where we help you apply the Bible to all of life's craziness. If you haven't subscribed yet,
what are you doing?
Bro, sis, go ahead and hit the subscribe button down below. We are on the road to 500 subscribers. Make sure you're telling all your family and friends about the videos that we're doing here. We are applying the Bible to everything. If you've seen any of my videos, you know I talk about fulfilling your God-given purpose all the time. And I just realized a couple days ago that I haven't even talked about how to find your God-given purpose. How do you discover what your purpose is? Your purpose will completely contextualize your entire life. It is of the utmost importance for you to figure out what you're here for, why you were born, what God created you to do. There's basically no important decision that you can make in your life without knowing your purpose. This is the most important video I have ever made. Point number one, you cannot be on purpose outside of God. Outside of Jesus. The one who loves money will never be satisfied with money. When you make more money, you want more things. You want a better life. You want more luxury. You're never going to be satisfied when you love money, when your pursuit is for money. Yes, you may be able to buy more things. Yes, you may be able to do more things and go more places. But if your life has no meaning, you will not be fulfilled. If you think your purpose is just to provide for your family, not to say that's a bad thing, but that too is futile. I mean, just think about it. Your family will eventually forget you. Don't believe me? Tell me, what is the name of your great, 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 great grandfather? What is his name and what did he do for a living? You don't know, do you? It's okay, the generations come and go. Life goes on. And I'm not saying you should not help your family. All I'm saying is that you fulfilling your God-given purpose is more important than even your family. It has to be the number one item on your to-do list. Point number two, the path that leads to your purpose is set before you, not by you. Proverbs 19:21, 16:9, Jeremiah 10:23. All three scriptures talk about the steps of man. And it indicates each time that God is the one that directs a man's steps, not us. There will be a supernatural set of indicators that lead you down the path of your God-given purpose. Imagine it like a divine GPS telling you which way to turn. This set of direction, this set of indicators, this set path will surpass any sort of idea you may come up with at any one time. These indicators will stick around for a long period of time. Your purpose most likely has already been revealed to you in many ways that you may have overlooked over time. You want to make sure you look back into your life. Some of the things that have happened to you don't really make sense. Some of the acceptances you've received, some of the denials you've received, some of the doors have been opened or closed in ways in which you had absolutely no control over. Pay attention to where these indicators are leading you. Remember, it is Him that directs your path and not you when it is your God-given purpose. Point number three. When you're in the Lord's purpose, everything may not make sense. Proverbs 20:24 states that God directs a man's way. Therefore, how can he understand his path? How can he understand his way? When the Lord is directing you, When the Lord is leading you down a pathway, not everything will make sense. You may not see the light at the end of the tunnel. You may not know how the dots are going to connect. You may not feel like you're going in a direction that makes the most sense to you. This is why Proverbs 3, 5, and 6 says, trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not into your own understanding. Remember, God's ways are not your ways or my ways. They are higher than both of our ways. Everyone on this earth cannot see the things that God sees, does not know the things that God knows, and cannot do the things that God can do. And so we must be okay with not understanding everything that's before us. When God is directing our path, when God gives us a vision, when God puts something in motion, we may not be able to see step 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9, but we know 10 is coming. We just have to have faith, and that's the point. This is why he doesn't just lay everything out for you like a storybook. He wants you to have faith in him. He wants you to rely on him to guide you. He wants you to trust in him with all your heart. And when you do that, you may not see how everything is supposed to connect. It may not be a mathematical equation, how your life will manifest itself, how your purpose will reveal itself. But that's okay. You can rest assured that if you're following through prayer and meditation, the indicators, the supernatural indicators that God has been giving you in your life, you are on the right path. Well, that's all I got for you for this part one of the Find Your Purpose series. Stay tuned for the next video, which will be dropping this Friday. Let me know down below if you find these points, these instructions helpful. I'd love to dialogue with you. That's all I got for you. My name is Zachary Carroll, aka Pastor Z. This is Christian Hood Talk. Y'all be cool.